Do you like candy? I like candy. Who doesn't like a sweet taste of candy every once in a while? And at this time of year, I've actually seen a lot of candy in the stores already with Valentine's Day right around the corner. There's a lot of tasty treats out there. And perhaps you have some favorites. I have Werther's. But you know what? Maybe a whole lot of candy isn't the best thing. Sometimes if you have too much, you can get a tummy ache or cavities. But do you want to know that there's something that is sweet and wonderful and won't give you cavities? It's the Word of God. Now, I know you can't eat a Bible. You can't chew on its pages, but we can chew on the Word. We can. We might not necessarily eat the Bible, but we can take in the Word and we can chew on it and we can digest it. And there's actually a passage in here that actually describes God's Word as being sweeter than honey. It's true. So stay with me as we explore God's Word and what it means to study God's Word and why perhaps we should even dig into God's Word. So welcome. Welcome to worship across time and space. My name is Pastor Janice, and it really is a privilege and a blessing to have you join us from your safe space as we continue to gather in person in our sanctuary as well as across time and space. And in this time of worship together, I'm coming to you from my office rather than the sanctuary. We can worship together in any place, actually. So again, I welcome you. So as we prepare to worship together, I invite you to pause and settle in as we prepare to spend some time. Take a nice deep breath in and out. And we're just going to play a little piece of music here as we continue to pause and breathe. And we're going to settle in to worship together. So here we are in the beauty of this moment. We come to worship God in our fellowship and joining across time and space. We come to worship God in the presence of the Holy Spirit. We have come to worship our Creator in the company of all creation. We worship Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So come. Let us worship, and I invite you to pray with me. Let's pray together, shall we? O God of wisdom and blessing, on this day we come into the warmth of your presence. Here we can find shelter in the strength of your promises. Here we can find welcome in your tender care. We are grateful for the protection that you provide. We're thankful for the comfort of your love. We offer our praise to you, for you give blessing when the world condemns. You give freedom when our culture confines. Lord, we ask that you embrace us in this time of worship together as we offer our love and our very selves in return. You are the God of the ages. We confess that the world's wisdom attracts us in advertising, in arguments. We fail to measure the messages out there according to your wisdom and your word. We find calls to speak out or to do justice too demanding, because the world has taught us to look out for ourselves first. Lord, forgive us. Renew us with your mercy and your love, so that we may walk more humbly with you, so that you, our leader, will guide us and we can walk firmly in your direction. We lay it all at the foot of the cross. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. And so, yes, as I mentioned earlier, it does say in our Holy Scriptures something about the words being sweet. And so we're going to turn and study some of those words now. And as we do, we pray that the Holy Spirit would open our minds and our hearts to new wisdom and understanding as we hear and read the living word. May we be transformed. Amen. And so we're going to turn first to the Psalms. Psalm 119, and I invite you to listen in as we start at verse 97, where our psalmist writes, "Oh, how I love your law. I meditate on it all day long. Your commands make me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. I have more insight than all my teachers, and I meditate on your statutes. I have more understanding than the elders, for I obey your precepts. I have kept my feet from every evil path so that I might obey your word. I have not departed from your laws, for you yourself have taught me." Now listen. "How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. I gain understanding from your precepts, therefore I hate every wrong path. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path." These are the living words of Scripture. And so now we're also going to turn to Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 10, starting at verse 4. So let's turn to Paul's letter to the Romans. We're just going to focus on a few verses in our time together. Romans chapter 10, starting at verse 4, where Paul writes, "Christ is the culmination of the law, so that there may be righteousness for everyone who believes. Moses writes this about the righteousness that is by the law. The person who does not have these things will live by them. But the righteousness that is by faith says, 'Do not say in your hearts, who will ascend to heaven, that is, bring Christ down, or who will descend into the deep, that is, to bring Christ up from the dead.' But what does it say? 'The word is near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart.' That is the message concerning faith that we proclaim. If you declare it with your mouth, 'Jesus is Lord,' and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. As Scripture says, 'Anyone who believes in him will never be put to shame.'" This is the living word. Thanks be to God. So why do believers study God's word? Why do we bother? That may seem like a silly question, especially when we understand that we hold within our hands the word of God. And so as believers or even as beginners, we want to hear what God has to say so that we can walk closely in relationship with our living Lord. And so there are actually several reasons to study God's word. Quite a few reasons, actually. Perhaps the first one might be to nourish and mature. See, reading and digging into the word here, it actually feeds our spirits. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2 actually reads, like newborn babies crave spiritual milk so that by it you may grow up in your salvation. So we read and study in order to grow. And we need to study the word, to dig into the word, to feed our spirit and to mature in our understanding. And while it's great and it's wonderful that we can gather like this across time and space and study some of God's word, but it's also something for us to do on our own, to actually read it, let it sink in, ask the question, what is it speaking to me? How might I understand it? Another reason we read and study God's word is so that we can stand strong. See, in Ephesians, it talks about the armor of God, and we're instructed to be strong in the Lord and in God's mighty power. Stand firm with the belt of truth buckled around your waist. That belt of truth is the truth of the word. And in the more studying and the more reading we do, we can stand firm, especially when it feels like we're being attacked by the world around us. We can stand firm in the promises of God that are given here in these living words of Scripture. And that belt of truth allows us to recognize the lies. So there's another reason to study God's word. Because when we come to know the truth, then we can recognize the lies around us. Even Jesus says, you know, watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name claiming to be the Christ. And we're called, you know, not to believe everything that's out there, but to test everything. And so as we read and study God's word, we come to know the truth and recognize the lies of the world around us. The truth that we can rely on God rather than ourselves. The truth of love and what is love and how we can live in love and how we can walk in the light. And reading and studying God's word allows us to know God, because God is revealed in these living words of Scripture. It's an incredible picture that God allows us to dig in, and we gain these aspects of God. We never get the whole picture of God, but we can study, you know, what is God like? We learn of God's love, God's mercy. For God so loved the world. How deep is God's love for us? So these words are a revelation of God to us as we draw closer to our God. As we study and read and read again, we learn in new ways. The psalmist David, as we read there, uses different analogies about God's word. God's law in the Old Testament times, God's law was the word. And David refers to the word as law, as precepts, as testimony, as rules. And with each reference to the word, David also lists a characteristic about it. Your word is perfect. The law is perfect. It's sure. It's right. It's clean. It's enduring. It's truth. And these give us the effects of God's word. And in doing so, as we continue to study and read and allow it to settle into us, we can find that we ourselves are nourished, that we are renewed, that we are enlightened. So as we read, and I do encourage you to read, do you just marvel at the contents of what's here? Or to the one to whom it points? So as we read, and especially if you read on your own, there are important questions to ask, right? What does this tell me about the character or the nature of God? Or how might God want to use this scripture to revive me or to renew me, to give me joy or even to give me wisdom? God speaks to us through these living words, revealing the nature of God, revealing the love of God. And through the word, we learn that our desire is for God. We want more. The word of God shows us that we're not perfect. And this illusion of control that we want to have on our life is truly an illusion. And the word of God actually shows us that we have an innate need, a need to be reconciled to this holy God that created us and God that loved us. And so the word of God points us to Christ. In the beginning was the word. There's all kinds of references there. And the word was God, and the word was with God. And Jesus is the word. So as we read and learn and study more, I'll say once again that these holy words of scripture are meant to be engaged. They're meant to be studied. They're meant to be talked about. They're even meant to be questioned. So it's good to come together and dig in and ask questions about the word, whether it's in small groups and such, because the word is meant to inspire and start conversations, not end them. And as we continue to read and study and explore, may we be brought into a deeper relationship with our God. May we spend time in God's word, thereby spending time with God. And so if you have questions about the Bible, about these holy words of scripture, I encourage you to reach out. Let's talk, as they say in the Bell Media campaign. Do talk, do question, do engage, do explore. Let's see what God's word says about this. Or how is this passage speaking to you? Or sometimes we just read the word and allow it to settle in and focus in on a particular word or phrase of a passage. We do that through the Lectio Divina. So yes, please read. Please study. Please have questions. If you have questions, reach out to me. I would love to connect. I'll throw my email address and phone number here at the church somewhere on the screen. We can talk. Let's talk. We can do it and have a conversation one-on-one, or we can have it in a small group. You can join us on Friday mornings and throw out a question there, or even join us for in-person worship, where we gather afterwards and share meals and snacks and coffee and such. It's good to have questions. Questions allow us to grow. Questions can allow us to grow closer to God. So you think about that. Alleluia and Amen. And so I invite you to pray with me. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, give us faith to receive your word, understanding to know what it means, and the will to put it into practice through Christ our Lord. We thank you for the gift of your holy words, your living words. May it indeed be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our very lives. Lord, I thank you for this time that you've given us to open your word and just discover who you are. Thank you that you don't leave us in the dark about who you are and what you're doing in the world around us, but that you are revealed through your living word, your sacred words to us. Blessed are you, our holy God, for you do indeed give release to the captives. You give food to the hungry. Bless us as we hunger and thirst for justice and righteousness in this world around us. May all who are needy find their hope in you. Compassionate God, we thank you for your mercy. You grant us pardon and forgiveness, and you call us to forgive others. Embrace us with your renewing grace, especially those who may be feeling resentful or discouraged. Help us serve as instruments of reconciliation, especially in places of conflict and discord. Lord, we ask that you tend and care to all who are suffering. Empower your people to act for good.
Bless the work of this thing we call church and our partners. Holy Spirit, sweep through our lives, our families, our communities. Caring God, we give you thanks for your comforts. You give us strength when we feel weak. You're there to pick us up when we fall. And we ask that you bless us as we support and care for one another, even within our own communities and homes. Lord, be with those who are mourning or grieving. May they find warmth in your love and light in the hope of Christ. Lord, we give you thanks that your word feeds us, nourishes us, sustains us. May we be strengthened by our common unity with the gifts that you've offered us through Christ Jesus. And so it is in the name of our blessed Jesus that we pray these words of scripture that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. As you go out into the rest of the world and the rest of the week, the rest of your day, with or without candy, may you be enriched, empowered, renewed, and refreshed. Go out and love extravagantly and unconditionally. The world out there waits for you. Waits for you that is the light of the Lord. So may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you. And the Lord lift up his countenance upon you. May the Holy Spirit wrap you in peace and in hope and in love. Be assured that you are loved by God, so go out and love on others. Thanks again for joining us. Amen.
Amen.